Yo, and Pete's looking like Marty McFly on that skateboard.
For real. But Back to the Future was kind of dope.
Yeah, but Marty was corny.
No, but remember he's playing the guitars, though. That was kind of lit.
Okay, that was dope. You're right.
You know what I'm saying?
And his girl not that bad, either.
You mean the mom? Or like the girlfriend?
His girlfriend.
Oh.
That's what I said, right?
Wait, is Marty McFly kind of lit?
You know what? He might be.
Should we make popcorn and watch that later tonight?
Not tonight, bro. I got a game. But be my guest, man.
No. I'll wait.
See? I knew you had it in you.
Come on, man.
That's good friendship right there, man. I appreciate you.
And I got you on, bro.
Yeah, you know
that's
that?
Very cute. Let's capture
aww,
this.
Oh, yeah. Hashtag friendship.
adorable.
Oh, yeah.
He's playing hard to get. It's all right.
Yeah.
It's good. We got one.
Oh, I'm hearing you're thinking about staying after all.
Yeah, things got a little emotional the other day, and this is where I want to be ultimately.
Great. Well, now all we got to do is game plan.
Oh, wait. So, Mila and I, we discussed, and we think we want to avoid the press in this. Just put my head down, focus, play the best basketball that I can play, because if Othello wants to trade me, he's going to be the one that looks like a clown, not me.
Okay, yeah, that is an option, but I don't think it's our best one here, man.
All right, then. Let me hear something.
Look, MP, you are a phenomenal player. I mean, you have unlimited potential, and you know I believe this, otherwise I wouldn't be here focusing all my energy on you like this. But right now, you've already got an uphill battle with the fans. And as it stands, if Othello leaks a trade rumor, you're gonna have half this city dancing in the streets.
Oh, come on, man. You don't think that's just a little too extreme right now?
Research shows that sports fans are 78% more likely to dance in celebration than any other type of fan, and that includes fans of ballroom dancing, funny enough.
Thanks, Ash.
Look, I'm not saying you can't do the whole good soldier routine, but, dog, to play so well that a trade is impossible without doing any maneuvering in the press, I mean, that's extremely difficult.
Impossible.
Look, why don't you just play as well as you can while trying to work the press in your favor? I mean, it's the best of both worlds.
But isn't doing all that behind-the-scenes stuff bad for my brand?
Exactly.
Like, Ashley, what do you think?
Okay, it's a possibility that it could hurt your image, but that is a very remote possibility, okay? No one will blame you for wanting to stay on your own team.
Mm-hmm.
It's okay. When you try to force your way out that there's a problem.
You know what? What if he's not comfortable trying to get another man fired?
Right. Okay.
I guess you guys haven't heard of the golden rule. Treat others as you would like to be treated.
Okay, fine. If that's the case, then we just won't do it at all. Does that sound good?
That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying you must not believe in his talent very well if you want him to beg, borrow, and steal to stay on the team.
If you want to control as many variables as possible, MP, you want to stay in this city, have a family with Mila like you plan to, you'll use every weapon at your disposal.
You can try and control all the things you want with all this shenanigans and still get traded. So it's how you want to sleep at night.
So it's really up to you, man. What are you feeling? You know how you want to play this?
Finn. I don't leave anything to chance. Let's request it go out. I want to earn my spot. That's right. I'm not this guy who's aggressive thing. Yeah.
Okay. Now, I just want to play this thing straight through. No press. Just pass.
Okay, MP, are you sure?
This is going to make things much more difficult for you. You understand that, right?
Maybe, but I never shy away from no challenge.
I'm proud of you.
Okay. Will that be in the case? This is what you're going to have to do to make this a viable option.
That's... Oh. We mean 10 points plus rebound. I don't know. Okay.
Told you this wasn't going to be easy. I'm not sure what you were expecting.
If you want to make your case on the court? It's going to have to be so crystal clear that any random fan on social media can see it.
You're right. Hey, this is what I wanted, man. I'm ready.
This is all gonna leak eventually, so the only thing that we can do is try to get ahead of it, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Hit those goals, then talk about them, mm-hmm. All right? You need to be your biggest advocate right now.
And I'm talking press conferences, scrums, every opportunity you get, you need to be talking up your accomplishments.
Strong, confident.
Yeah, you can deliver the message however you want, but you need to deliver it. You are the one that can bring this team to the promised land. Mm-hmm. Not this season, then sometime real soon.
No, not real soon. We need now. All right, you need to be a championship-caliber centerpiece in order for this to
hey,
work.
Hey, that's easy, man, because I already am.
That's what I'm talking
already
about. Am. That's the confidence we need.
Come on, man. Anything else?
Nah, that's it. Look, you want to win this war on the court, then go win it. Ain't nothing left to do now but go ball.
My man.
My man.
She said, boy, you nice. Boy, you nice. Heart cold like some water and some ice. I just wanna slide. Parties in the sky like it's 2055. She said, boy, you nice.
What's up, 2K? This is a video right now. I'm going to change my number to 20 to 43. Well, because of a legend in Melbourne United. But, and number 2, because there's a bit disrespect to wearing number 20. It should be retired, but let's get to this game.
MP, talk already.
What's going on, man?
I am so glad to meet you, man. I've been dying for a tete-a-tete with you. I am a fan of you, sir.
Okay. You been in any games lately?
Games?
Oh, yeah.
No.
Why not?
I am not a fan of basketball, sir. I find sports to be a frivolous distraction.
You look like you balled before, man.
I mean, come on. Compliments are good, but listen. To each his own. We all can't have the same interest, but look, I'm a fan of you, the human being.
Okay.
All
right.
Thank you, Roberta.
Thank you very much.
And what you did for Carl Beam. In his quest to find a home for his hot dogs, I mean, inspiring is an overused word, MP, so I'll say things like uplifting, heartening, motivating.
All I did was put the word out, man. I didn't do much.
And yet you saved a man's life. It reminds me of Shannon Sadler. Have you ever heard of her?
No, I don't think so.
17-year-old entrepreneur. She developed a new and exciting way to send electricity to northern Lapland regions of remote Finland, MP. What I'm saying is you are motivating me. You've outdone yourself, gal.
It's all for you, Peter.
If you don't stop it. Chef's kiss. Anyways, MP, what I mean to say is what can I do for you, my friend?
I was actually hoping I could pick your brain for a little bit.
MP, I'm an open book.
Cool.
Ask, what can I help you with?
Okay, cool. So my agent Ricky, huge fan of yours.
As he should.
Okay. He was hoping that maybe we could have a sit down, you know, talk about some things to work on together kind of thing.
Huh.
Yeah, something like that.
I like this Ricky fellow.
Yeah, he's super cool. You guys would definitely hit it off.
Okay, let's take a seat and talk about this. I have this leadership conference coming up. Yeah. Okay. And I think it would be exactly what you need for you to harness the best versions of yourself. You see, at this conference, we'll teach you about the foundational mindset and what it is exactly that you're missing out there on the floor.
Wait, hold on. I mean to cut you off, but I don't think I was clear back there.
Huh.
What I'm really, really looking for is a partnership. 50-50, you and I.
Equals.
Yeah.
Look, confidence is an important quality for a leader.
For sure.
And at this conference, not only will you learn about confidence, but you also learn what is necessary for you to be successful.
I also have a lot of experience in leadership. I got that covered.
You do?
Yes.
Okay. Do tell.
All right. Start. Okay, so I led a team of 18 to 21-year-olds, collegiate athletes, to a national championship before I even discovered that I wanted to be a national basketball player in the world's most competitive league. I mean, manifesting accomplishments of that level, of that quality, at that age, I don't know, man. That's hard to find.
No, that's impressive and interesting. Which leads me to think of something I never thought about before. MP, what do you think about the leadership panel?
Ooh, 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 ooh.
Hmm?
All right, I can dig that. Talk to me. Is it like an open audience kind of vibe to ask you questions?
Yeah, more or less. It's a group of highly respected individuals from a diverse set of backgrounds having an open and honest conversation in front of a live studio audience.
Hmm? That's fire.
That's fire?
That's fire.
You know, MP, I kid you not, sir, I am thinking this is prophetic. You know, Shannon Sadler's parents just called me, and she's been grounded. You know, she stayed out late on her curfew, and I have been looking for someone else to fill in this panel. And if you would be willing to post about this on your social media, and bring a new audience to this thing, I think there might be a spot on this panel for you. That's it. Just post.
Man, you ain't say nothing but a word.
A word?
Watch this. Done.
Done?
Done.
Just like that?
Just like that.
Hey.
Come on now.
All right now.
I'm serious.
Okay. All right, you know what, MP? This is good. You know, good or bad, win or fail, whether you fall flat on your face, this will allow us for us to see exactly what it's going to take for you to take the next level.
And those are the words I live by, Peter. Truly.
It's Peter. The name. It's Peter.
I didn't mean any disrespect by that. I'm sorry about that. So just have your team email my team the details, and we good. I'll be there.
We're good?
We're good.
Ah, c'est bien. Okay. Good.
Let's do it.
What's up? What's going on?
You know, I can't lie. I'm just a little bit nervous about this leadership panel.
Nervous?
A little bit.
Okay, why though? You answer questions from the press all the time.
No. I know I answer questions from the press, but they can literally ask me anything they want. Like, at least I know with the press guys, either I played well or I did bad or we won or we lost. With them, it's no surprises. With the other people, I don't know.
You know, I can,
right?
I can go with you, man. I mean, if you want. And then you can introduce me to Mr. Abbott, and we could form like a mutual mentorship program.
Oh boy. This is a good thought, okay? You're right, this conference could make or break you in this borough. So, let's just run some potential questions.
Ask some questions.
Okay.
Good idea.
Yeah, good idea. Go.
Good idea.
Shoot.
Okay. MP, what is the biggest challenge that you faced as a leader?
Okay.
Good question.
That's a really good one. I think it's getting a group of guys to think together as a team, coming from different backgrounds, different motivations, and success only comes from putting all that aside and uniting under one goal. Uh-huh. How's that sound?
That's fantastic. You're going to do
something I would have written for you. That's,
That's good.
Yeah, high praise.
Unfortunately, we kind of got bigger problems right now.
Oh, come on, man.
What?
Well, you know how after you met with Peter, you posted, super excited to be joining the keynote panel for Peter Abbott's Foundational Thinking Leadership Conference,
okay,
right?
Did I spell something wrong in there?
No.
Did I use the wrong your?
I hate that.
People hate that. Well, no, I didn't even use your.
No. It's...
What is it?
Shep just responded.
Oh, come on.
Look, he said, props to MP for getting a jump start on his coaching career. You know what they say, those that can't do, teach, and those that can't teach, coach. I always felt MP looked most at home on the bench.
Ignore him.
No, you can't ignore that. Not after we've established your image as somebody who puts people in their place.
Yeah,
right.
Exactly.
I thought we were trying to paint MP as a potential business leader, not someone who's drawn into petty online beefs. Right? I mean, up to you, but... I don't think people even care what Shep says. It's just all a game to him.
Lonzo the Crown just responded with eyes emojis, so...
Love it.
Oh, that's bad. Yeah. Do nothing, and you lose all your online support. Not to mention, you're going to lose all the cred that you earned from those skaters.
No, and we cannot have that at all.
We cannot have that.
Why don't you just clap back at him for looking at your page so hard? Like, why you got my post notifications on?
Remind him who's got the championship ring.
That part.
Right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Tell him not to be so jealous that people actually want to hear what you have to say.
Okay.
He's a tweeter. You're a leader.
Ooh, that's good.
All right.
That's good.
You know what? It is good, but it's also petty.
Oh.
I think you should say you would be honored to coach someday. I mean, you're all about lifting up the people around you.
Yeah, that's the more mature response.
Boring.
All right, look, honestly, it's up to you, man. So what do you want to do?
Oh. Beyond our being successful makes him maybe understand that one. Oh, being successful makes me a natural leader. Maybe you'll understand that one day. Yeah, that's the one.
It's not petty if it's true. I'm surprised you saw this post even though your name wasn't mentioned.
Ooh.
People normally follow people with success. I hope you find that out someday. I'm starting to really enjoy going at that little knucklehead.
Mm-hmm. That's that competitive
fire
right there.
Come on, give me some, baby.
All the grace got it.
clapback methods.
Come on, come on now.
Mama very well in the online sports space.
Hey, okay. You feeling better about the panel?
What you think, I'm feeling?
Come on, talk about
it. I feel good.
Talk about it.
I'm gonna talk about it.
I'm gonna let him know too. Friendly reminder that it does take place after your next game, so don't be late.
Really, Ashley?
Really?
I got this. I'm not gonna be late. I got you.
You've been late for a few dates recently.
Oh.
All right. Well, this is turning into a personal issue, but don't start messing up now, okay?
I got you.
Okay.
Hey, go get him, Tiger. I'll see you later.
I'm gonna go, but all right.
We got another video of 2K23 in my career.
And so off the tip, it's Boston. And both teams tonight unafraid to run offense through their bigs, Grant. Talk about the value of being able to do that.
Yeah, BA, you know, it just speaks to how both teams can beat you in multiple ways.
Easy layup. He can lead to higher we need a W. With the bigs running the offense, you can strike a nice balance between
inside and out, which coaches are preaching right now.
Jokic with a screen on MP.
Good day.
Oh, it's blocked by Williams.
Oh, he's open. For the splash, Green Jelly.
Two for two. He's in his rhythm.
He's consistent.
Foremost, he's a pass-first team player. It's Caldwell Pope. Love seeing that.
And a Caldwell Pope playing for
Gallinari with a screen on Murray.
Let's see.
Outside Tatum.
Go for the screen.
Gallinari with a screen. Here's Man.
Easy layup. Let's go.
Nice feed that
too
time.
Too easy, 2K.
Man's got nine.
Hey, defenders already have a lot to worry about with Tatum scoring. If he's making passes like that too, watch out.
Hall of Fame CPU, you're not ready.
Murray
good
passes
D.
to Gordon.
Great D. Let's
that
go.
Three's off the
let's
mark.
Go. Playing now.
Five out there, but no
I'm all the way.
Just keep
come on, Jokic.
His man.
Give me the foul, Jokic. Oh, try to pump fake that thing. Yeah.
Missing Jamal Murray and Michael Porter Jr.
Green.
Denver managed
give
to finish sixth in the West last year.
And you know the reason they did that was because of the MVP, Nikola Jokic. I mean, he was the guy who carried them to that sixth-place finish
football.
In the West.
Not
don't forget about role guy. Well, he's really been on a roll this quarter. Seems like everything he throws
a set of
up,
screens, it just
bottom.
Works.
Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they
good
really
day.
Need to find a way to get back on track.
Murray, no good. The Celtics with the lead.
Just can't stay on me, Murray. He just can't stay on me. Ah, you're there, Aaron Gordon.
Headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Really left him no choice there.
Easy.
He had the foul and keep him from diverting the easy bucket.
And a look at how the offensive approach has been going so far for the Celtics.
At all. I mean, they've really made a point to get the ball down inside and challenge that interior defense.
Ah, didn't mean to do that.
Now here's MP.
Go Brown, all the way! The 7-point lane.
Boy, so much fun seeing facing the floor. Contavious Caldwell-Pope has gone from an average outside shooter to a dangerous one.
Let's see if we can get Murray.
MP against Murray.
I'm fake. Easy layup.
And he banks in the layup.
Put your he's hands up, teams. Mate. Not jumping. Come on. Good D. Come on.
Just five on the clock.
D. No way.
And the three off target.
Oh,
Boston,
fast break again.
7 of 11 shots to find the mark.
Oh, all the way again.
He throws it down.
All the way with the easy dunk.
He just took over himself.
What a show of power right there from the point.
Standing first quarter from the field.
You're exactly right. I mean, everything seems to be dropping.
Ah, what a step back.
And that streaking rack attack is the mobile one drive.
You're toasting the defense and getting in close.
All the way
again. All day. They played
oh,
with
there
fantastic
he is.
Energy from the opening
all day long. Phenomenal use of the screen there.
You know, one measure of Nikola Jokic's growth as a player is his triple-double tally. I mean, he's already...
Oh, ankle break. Ankle break! Get down to the ground! Look at that. Oh, my God. He just got ankle breaked. Get out of here, mate. You're not ready. I wish I dropped him. Like the legendary Chris Move says... You need a map. Where are you going, mate? Oh my god.
Here's Murray.
Get out of here.
Blocked by Williams. They recover it. Outside Murray.
Good over day. MP. Give me that block. Come on.
Williams, a screen on Murray.
Easy assist. MP, let's go. Williams punches it home. That's okay. Easy
impressive
assist.
One hit. Look. This package that Jokic has, instinct, length, timing, you don't have to jump really high if you've got those things working for you to be effective as a rebounder.
Williams passes to Williams, deflects the
good
pass.
Good dunk!
And Williams punches it home.
And this guy, to me, embodies determination. Small in his position, but he still gets up and keeps plays alive. That's mind over matter for sure.
Murray against MP.
Good day.
From 12.
Again, going for the pull-ups.
Murray can't get that one to fall.
Pass.
Oh, man, he can't get anything to fall.
Oh, green splash. What a great. Let's go.
Nuggets trail. Pass to Caldwell Pope. Three-pointer. Rebound Boston. Defeated by Detroit in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind.
Oh, Tatum is
really
done.
That hell has to fall on their defense or a lack thereof.
Jason Tatum is done.
Yeah, and that's really inexcusable. I mean, there's just no way that you.
As a visiting team.
You know, the defense had no answer for him. To do that kind of damage on the road, impressive.
Here's Highland.
Good day.
And another miss by Denver. And
his give it to me. All the way with the foul.
Whistle on the shot. Misses the shot, but he'll shoot two.
Damn.
Man, he made sure to get his money's worth on that foul. He got in good. Damn. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
Sweet.
Man,
both free throws lead.
Good for position. And in 2022, more history made by Nikola Jokic, becoming the first player to amass 2,000 points, 1,000 rebounds, and 500 assists in a single season.
Tatum with a good assist. You see that assist by Tatum? Behind the back.
Showing off some style. Wow, that was
time
stuff. 100% free throwing for the quarter. That's superb.
That's what he does. Rock solid at the line.
7 seconds. And then you go for the screen. Doesn't work, really.
Pass to Jokic. Over Williams.
Good day.
And so it's the Boston Celtics. They lead by 11.
11-point lead.
Comes to a close. Gordon against Gallinari. Outside. Green. No good from outside. Green's gone. 1-for-3 on the night. Murray against MP. Nice move. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting. Jamal Murray, second. It's going to be on Jamal Murray. Free throw good, MP. And both free throws good for MP. A little over a minute gone here in the second half. Here's Murray. Some solid defense from Williams.
Well, guys, they need to do something to reduce this deficit. We'll see if that's the answer.
MP outside. Gallinari with a screen on Murray. Oh, there's the alley! And Gallinari throws it down.
And the lead increases on a crazy offensive. Clearly the better team.
The Nuggets with another miss.
It's clear he's totally out of sync. The team needs to rethink its strategy around what to do with him.
And Williams punches it home.
The ball distribution was there. I mean, outstanding work all the way around.
In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket. You know, he's been off tonight, off his game. At this point, he might want to focus on creating for others.
They're making it look easy out there. Just half the left iron. And for the Nuggets, they're shooting only 30% in the third quarter. Gordon outside. He can't get it to go. Some solid defense from Williams.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. it seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
MP against Murray. Shot clock at 6. Williams with the screen. Brown passes to Williams. And a great assist by Brown as that one goes in. Williams is... Here's Reed, defended by Smart. Pass to Smith. Lets it go from the wing. The rebound, Celtics. Williams has got rebound number 15 here tonight. There's the screen by Johnson. Down low. Soft touch off the glass.
I like the play call. Very solid, making perfect use.
Gordon with it. Here's Reed. Green, the pass to Jordan. Shoots over Johnson. And that one's long. Boston's gone. Only 1 of 3 from deep here in the third. Here's Mann. Oh, and the dunk by MP.
BA, the one-hand dunk.
The Nuggets have gone 3 of 5 since this fourth quarter started. To the wing on the left. Murray for 3. And it's Jason Tatum with a rebound. The Celtics have gone 1 of 4 since the fourth quarter began. Gallinari with a screen on Murray. Back to Tatum. Cash. It's MP picking up the assist.
Tatum.
Boston's gone 1 for 3 in the fourth quarter from range. Williams with the screen. MP, the pass to Williams. And Williams punches it home.
That one rocked this arena.
That's the kind of dunk right there that makes you think he's got that one. And it's Denver the other way.
You know, it hasn't been his best outing, but they still find themselves in the driver's seat here.
MP against Murray. Pass to Jokic. Some solid defense from Williams.
Boy, just cannot buy a bucket, guys. I tell you what, that's a painful quarter for him, and it's painful for me to watch, too.
Outside Tatum. Back to Mann. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting.
If they keep hitting free throws at this clip, it'll help them seal the deal. Yeah, they've not missed a single foul shot this half, and that's taking care of business, fellas.
Gordon, he's checked in for the Nuggets. Hitch has got his fourth assist with that last one. The Celtics have gone 5 of 11 so far in the fourth. MP outside. Outside, Williams. MP outside. Oh, and the dunk by MP.
And despite the height...
Oh, now Jokic can definitely throw it down, and he's happy to remind defenses that he can do so.
The drive by Mann. Oh, another one falls.
My goodness, 50 for the
right to treat the players as if they're not human. And we've seen fans cross the line in that regard. That's unacceptable. As a player, your impact is best felt on the court. So you have to control your emotions, but the fans and the venues have a
quarter.
When you can shoot the ball like Jokic can from every level, that kind of versatility makes you a hard guard. And making mid-range shots just adds to his dangerousness.
And a foul call.
Jamal Murray, fourth personal foul, second team foul.
The officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
Well, Grant, the NBA has led the way when it comes to diversity and representation in high-level jobs. Grant, what are your thoughts on it?
Yeah, B.A., I love this. I mean, the NBA really, truly has been a leader when it comes to this. Whether it's coaches, front office, in the league office in New York, living and embodying the spirit of diversity and inclusion is what the NBA is all about. It's fun to be a part of.
The NBA, where everyone is welcome.
Everyone loves the alley-oop play, B.A.
Yep, one of the prettiest in here in the second half. Boston's gone just 1 of 6 from downtown in this final quarter. MP, the pass to Tatum. Now MP. And he lobs it up, and Williams punches it home.
He's pouring it on at a nice clip, and the rest of the team is stepping up as well.
More time.
And one player just stole the show tonight, doing everything for his team. A monster night for MP.
Boy, he was absolutely relentless at the offensive end, guys. Smelled blood and went for it.
Hits yet again. Wow!
That's 52 points for him. It's nice they found their rhythm here, but the clock is just not their friend. Now they're playing with urgency. Huh. They could have done it much earlier before the game was out of reach.
MP, the pass to Gallinari. And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. They didn't have too many problems tonight.
They didn't. Just a tremendous... Get started. And my man Johnny, look, what you got for me today?
Nice game tonight. What was the key to your success out there?
My man John always got the good questions, man. I can always depend on you, brother. Yeah, I mean, this team trusts each other, you know, to be in the right spot at the right time and to make the right decisions as well. You know, when that happens, it brings the best out of everybody on that floor.
Always a team player. Thanks, MP.
Not a problem.
What happens if an effort like tonight isn't enough?
Enough for what?
Enough to win.
I mean, okay, if that happens, I'll do what I always do. Go back with my team and figure out what we need to do to get better. Nothing changes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Seems like we're done here, huh? All right, see you guys later.
Wow, total domination from start to finish tonight. What happened out there? The game was over before it started.
You know what, Nate? I'm just really happy for the guys on the bench. You know, the guys who got some run tonight who usually don't. You know, they're gonna be important for us as the season goes on and really help us flesh out this rotation.
Yeah, you guys got contribution all over the court tonight. Does that depth give you an advantage, though?
Oh, definitely, man, definitely does. You know, like I said, we can go two or three deep at every spot on the court. You know, not a lot of teams can say that, so. You know, it's a long season, and having those hands on deck can be the difference between, you know, home court advantage and the playing game, you know?
Yep.
Good game tonight. They really struggled to get you under control on the offensive end.
Yeah, they did, didn't they?
They sure did. So how did you do it?
You know, I give a lot of credit to the guys on the bench tonight. You know, they really came out and brought energy, especially on the defensive end. You know, when you could take out your starters and not lose any of that intensity, it makes, you know, winning a lot easier.
Oh, come on, you're being modest. The bench was great because you were the star tonight.
Thanks, Candace. But I'm just trying to play my role, you know. My teammates were telling me to shoot more and I just tried to listen. You know, I can't expect to score like this every night, but we are trying to win every game.
Well, keep playing like this and it won't be a problem.